أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهديه الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له من دون الله وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله رب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس، الحمد لله الفرد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. أما بعد، إن دنوه فالله the most beneficent the most merciful. All praise and thanks due to Allah, the Lord of the world, and peace and blessing upon the last of the Prophet and Messengers, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and upon his family and his companions and whoever follow him with the benevolence till the day of resurrection. My dear respected brother and sister Islam, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As we mentioned today, inshallah, it's going to be the last Friday before the big season of the good deed, inshallah, Ramadan. So it's not the last, it's just the last Friday before Ramadan. And Ramadan, inshallah, very hard work for everybody, inshallah. But today is a special night because of we got too much sweet. That's why it's a special night. There is some brother, Toyota Blue, BJ2150, or SO. He's blocked the way outside. Nobody? Twitter. Twitter blue. All right. Nobody, alhamdulillah. Anything outside. So inshallah, today is special night regarding few things to learn, inshallah, together, which I know, alhamdulillah, brother, they got this knowledge. But just as Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned in the Quran, وَذَكِّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. We always remind each other. And this reminder, it helps the believer so they can correct themselves, they can remember things. Sometimes we forgot. And sometimes we do mistakes, not on purpose. But because Ramadan is very important for all the Muslims, we should to cover all the ahkam and the role, so we'll be in the safe side, inshallah. Because it's not easy to miss Ramadan. As we said today in the khutbah, Ramadan is a great chance for Allah Azza wa Jalla to forgive you, for the Muslim to get forgiveness from Allah Azza wa Jalla. As we said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, من صام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه وما تأخر. غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whoever fast Ramadan for sake of Allah azza wa jal, Allah will forgive all his past. And another chance, من قام رمضان إيمانا واحتسابا, whoever pray tahajjud for Allah azza wa jal is sick, غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه, Allah عز وجل will forgive all his sins. And another chance, من قام ليلة القدر إيمانا واحتسابا, whoever pray the ليلة of the قدر, the night of the قدر, for Allah عز وجل is sick, Allah عز وجل will forgive all his sins. So it's a great chance. Even every day Allah عز وجل free nicks from the hellfire. So it's a great chance for all the Muslims to do the best to get away from the hellfire, to do the best to get the forgiveness of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Ramadan ila Ramadan kafaratun lima baynahuma. Between Ramadan and Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive all your sin. If you fast this Ramadan and you fast last Ramadan, Allah Azza wa Jalla forgive for you inshallah whatever between Ramadans, between the two Ramadans. It's a great chance. But the only thing, some people sometimes they don't know the roles. And some people, of course, if you don't know the role in Islam, the Sharia doesn't ask you about anything. Only one thing. If you don't want to know the role, I don't care, I don't want to know, you'll be judged for that. Because you got the option, you got the chance to learn, but I don't want. Or a person is very shy. He don't want to do anything because he's shy. Also, these will be judged. Because there is no shyness in the ilm, in the knowledge. You have to ask. Or a person is arrogant. Someone, he think, I know everything, I don't need to come to the masjid to waste my time for 1 hour. Subhanallah, there is no wasting, of course, as we know. But some people, they think so. I know everything. Why should I sit here and I listen to the same thing I heard every time? But sometimes I forget things, sometimes I need to remember, sometimes anything new, I learn it. So inshallah, we'll go through a few roles in Ramadan. And also, if inshallah have a question, we can inshallah answer the question, so everybody inshallah can get what they need. First, my brother, the definition of the fasting is to stop eating and drinking. That's in general. person, if we say a person is fast, he doesn't eat, he doesn't drink. From the Fajr until the Maghrib. That's the definition of the fasting. A person stop eating and drinking from Fajr until Maghrib time. Fasting is fard. As Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned that in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. Oh, who you believe, the fasting of Ramadan, it's obligatory among you as it was obligatory for the people before you. And the reason of the fasting, to get the taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. To reach to the taqwa of Allah Azza wa Jal. So now, what is the condition of the siyam? What should, as a Muslim, I start do? The first thing, my brother, and that's in general, for any obligatory, for any action you do, for sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, your intention first. No one can do any action without intention, especially in the fard. In the fard, you cannot do the intention after the action. In the sunnah, yes, you can do that. But in the fard, you have to do the intention first, and then you start act. So before you pray, you must have your intention first. You're going to pray Dhuhr or Asr or Maghrib or Isha or Fajr. You must have the intention. But in the sunnah, if you wanted to pray 2 rak'ah and then in the sunnah you wanted to make it 4. So right, you can do. In the fasting, you wake up in the morning and you didn't have breakfast till Dhuhr time. And you ask your wife, do we have any food today? No, we don't have food yet. So right, I'll continue fasting in the sunnah. But not in the fard. In the fard, you must make the niyyah, the intention before Fajr. That's obligatory. You cannot do the intention after Fajr. You must do it before Fajr. So how many niyyah I need for Ramadan? Every night? The majority of the ulama said you need at least 1 niyyah from the beginning of the month for the whole month. And if you can do it every day, that's fine. But you have at least to make 1 niyyah from the beginning of the month, I'm going to fast the whole month of Ramadan. So at least 1 niyyah from the beginning of the month of Ramadan, you must have it. And then if every night before Fajr you can remember to renew your intention, it's good to do it, no problem at all. But at least you make it. So if one day you slept over and you wake up after Fajr, what can I do now? I'm going to continue fasting or not? Of course I have, but if I don't have intention, I cannot continue. That's why the first intention, the beginning of the month, cover for you the whole month. So if one day you slept over, or one day you're sick, or whatever, one day you forget to make the niyyah, the first niyyah cover for you the whole month. So it's very important to do the niyyah before you start. The Prophet ﷺ, he is to always do the niyyah before Fajr, and if in the sunnah, he is to ask for food. As we know, the Prophet ﷺ sometime for 3 months, there is no cooking in his house. The Prophet ﷺ, his main dish was the water and the dates. That's what the Prophet ﷺ used to eat. That's his main dish. Our main dish, meat and chicken. And the Prophet ﷺ, his main dish every day, water, al-aswadayn, water, and dates. That's it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every 3 moons, they used to see there is fire coming from the house of the Prophet. There is cooking there. There is cooking there by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in the sunnah, the Prophet is to ask if there is food, it's alright, he eat. If there is no food, he continue fasting. In the fard, he never do that. He is to fast, he is to have the niyyah before the fard of the salah. What is allowed for me? What is allowed for some people to break the fast? There is some people, Islam or the Sharia, give them permission to break the fast without judge. Allah Azza wa Jal give the permission for the person who's sick. If somebody's sick, he can, it's not any sickness. Like if somebody just like had like a little flu, he can take it, whatever, that's fine, he can continue fasting. But if something can harm him, something he need medicine, the doctor said you have, and the faqih, in this case, is a doctor, not the sheikh. Like if the doctor say, you have to break your fast because it's dangerous on you, you must break your fast. If the sheikh say no, don't break your fast, you don't listen to the sheikh, listen to the doctor. Because he's a faqih of this area. He knows this thing can harm you. And Islam, he never allow us to harm ourselves or to harm someone else. So if the doctor said you have to break your fast, you have to take this medicine in this time, you have to break your fast. But the, if the doctor said, you know what, you can take this medicine in the other time, like during the day you take it three times, take it during the night. Same thing. So you don't have to break your fast. So the doctor, he knows. He's not going to harm you. So the marid, the sick person, or the lady when she got the period time, or after she give birth. After she give birth, also she cannot be fast as long as she's bleeding. When she stop bleeding, she can start, if she can, she can start fast again. Alright? So these people, Allah Azza wa Jal, tell them. Also, if a pregnant woman, or a woman she breastfeeding, and she know that can make her weak, she cannot continue, she can break her fast as well. A pregnant woman, she think that would be dangerous on her child, because the child eat from her, and the doctor advise her, you have to eat a lot, you need to take some medicine, whatever. This woman also, she can break her fast. Also the old people, very old people, they cannot fast anymore. They need to eat, they got diabetic, they got whatever. They can't fast. Allah Azza wa Jal, He ordered them to break the fast. So now, if somebody sick, or somebody also traveling, Allah Azza wa Jal give him permission to break his fast. فَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَىٰ سَفَرٍ فَعِدَّةٌ مِنْ أَيَّامٍ أُخْرَىٰ. So the sickness, or the traveling, or a woman in her bleeding time, whatever period of time, or whatever after giving birth, or a woman, she's pregnant, or a woman, she's breastfeeding, or old people, they cannot fast. They need to eat. They're very hungry. So these people, Allah Azza wa Jal allow them to break the fast. Of course, we're going to know these people, everyone, if he breaks his fast, what should he do? Because there is some people, they will break the fast, but they have to do it the days again. Or some people, they have to pay fidya. Or some people, they must make kafara. We know the difference, inshallah, now. Kids, please, in the back. Can the kids keep quiet, please? Can the kids, please, in the back, keep quiet? From the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when you break your fast, he is to break his fast on two things, as we said, the aswadain, water or dates. To start with that, that's a sunnah. If you wanna to do it for sake of Allah Azza wa Jal, to follow the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What is allowed for the person when he fasts? When in the fasting in Ramadan, you allow to eat and drink after Maghrib. That's very easy, isn't it? Of course. But after Maghrib, everybody is going to break his fast. So you're allowed to eat and drink after Maghrib. You're allowed to have your wife after breakfast. That's allowed for you. You also allow, and the sunnah, to delay the suhoor, the eating in the night, in the morning, like before Fajr. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to order the Sahaba to continue eating until to hear until finish the first adhan, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to let the Sahaba do two adhan. So when the first adhan start, he tells the Sahaba continue eat, no problem. But when the adhan finish and the other adhan is going to start, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam order them to stop eating. And that's the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In the hadith he said, my ummah will be in the good as much they delay the suhoor and to earlier the breakfast, to make the breakfast early. Because some people, they wait until they see the stars in the sky and then they start eat the breakfast. And that's not from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Also, if somebody wake up in the morning and they find himself junub, he need to wash. And that was after Fajr. Did that break his fast or anything? Nothing. He's allowed to be in this situation. He wake up, he make his ghusl, and continue your fasting. Nothing to do with your fasting at all. If something like that, if a person also he eat and he forgot, I can't remember, I'm fasting, so I start to eat and drink. In this case, the Prophet ﷺ said, that's a gift from Allah Azza wa Jal. Allah gifted you, Allah give you some gift. So all what you do, if you remember, you have to stop. Because some people, I know, the chocolate, oh, mashallah, and they start to eat, and Subhanallah, I'm fasting. Yeah, Allahu Akbar, I'm fasting and we continue eating. And then after I finish, oh, Subhanallah, I forgot. I know Sheikh Ibn Saudiyah, he do that. No? All right. Also allow, inshallah, to use the miswak. The miswak is sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the miswak, it's the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he ordered sahaba, he said, لَوْلَا أَشُقَّ عَلَى أُمَّتِي. If I don't want to make it hard on my ummah, I will order them to use the miswak for every salah. So it's a sunnah for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You always use it in the fasting time. If somebody use eye drop or anything like air drops, anything like that, as long as it doesn't go to his stomach, that also doesn't break your fast. It's allowed to do it. It's allowed to use this kind of things, as long as it doesn't go to your stomach. It's very important, it doesn't go to your stomach. It doesn't go to your blood to feed you. But if just like eye drop and doesn't go to the stomach, air drops or anything like that, the ulama said it's allowed because it doesn't reach to your stomach. Sometimes when the Ramadan comes in the very hot time, some people they need to wash so they can to refresh themselves, or they need to make wudu too much and rinse them out. All this halal, but don't do it too much. And while you rinse, you leave some water inside so you can drink it after. So don't be smart, because Allah Jalla knows. Like always things. Some people they think Allah Jalla knows. You left some water inside. So rather to get it out and then you just let your mouth to get, because sometimes it's really hot. So it's halal to wash, it's halal to make wudu, and all the things is halal. Nothing wrong with that, but you be careful to make any things. There is also some things, if a person do it, it can break his fast. So all the things halal to do it. You can, if you eat and you forget, it's no problem. You can wash, you can rinse your mouth in between. All the things, even also if somebody cooking, our sister, when she cook, and she wanted to taste the food, it's allowed for her to taste the food, but on the tongue. Just because subhanAllah, that's the way the taste. But you don't have to take one spoon of rice to eat it, to taste the food. Because maybe somebody like, you want to just to make sure the food is like done, that rice, Haris, when you cook, you do that? In Ramadan? Not in Ramadan? Alhamdulillah. So when the person you wanted to taste the food just on the tongue, and you know that salty, you need to put more salt, whatever, that's halal, nothing wrong, it doesn't break your fast at all as well. A person who eat and drink in front of you, he forgot, he doesn't remember. What is your obligatory for him? You feel sorry for him? Let him continue eat haram? He's hungry?
Remind,
but the brother is going to be angry at you. Because why you remind me? Let me finish and they remind me. But your job is to remind him. Because the Prophet said, مَنْ رَأَ مِنْكُمْ مُنْكَرًا فَلْيُغَيِّرُ. You have to tell him, brother, it's far. Oh, thank you, brother, but he's not happy inside. He's telling you thank you, but he's not happy. Because he wish if you leave him just until he drink his water. But your obligatory is to remind the brother, to tell him, brother, it's Ramadan, he forgot. So you have to do it. So some people, they said, oh no, it's all right, I let him to get some something, but it's not allowed to do that. It's haram for you. Allah Ajal is going to ask you, not asking him. Because you're the one who sees the things, but you didn't like you don't care. So if a person, of course, like any injection, and of course Dr. Muhammad, you know that very well, is like vitamins or anything like that, is not allowed. Because that's like something give you more energy, more power. And anything to go to your stomach or to go mix with the blood for giving you energy, it's not allowed. It can break your fast. It can break your fast. So you don't go and you take some injection to give you power or to give you energy just to continue your day. Because Islam is very easy. The Sharia, the law, is very easy. Kids, could you please listen? Thank you. So the Sharia is very easy. Allah Ajal make it easy for us. If you're sick, if you cannot fast, there is a solution for you. Don't worry. But if you can, don't try to go and to make excuse for yourself to get some energy, vitamins or anything like that. It will break your fast. So you're not allowed to take any of these injections. Any of the things, my brothers, for the person to tell him your fast has been broke, he must have three conditions. First, he know the role. He know the role. Like a person, if a person slept with his wife during the day of Ramadan, that can break his fast. But if the person doesn't know, and of course there is fidya, there is kafara, we'll talk about it inshallah. But if the person doesn't know, he doesn't go for kafara. Nobody learned, teach him. He doesn't know that. So the first condition, he must know the role. And the second, he while he's doing the things, he knows he's fasting. Because if you forgot, if a person eat and drink, or a person like do anything what he forgot, Allah Azza doesn't judge him for that. So that's second condition. The third, if there is like, he had his option, like nobody forcing him. Like if somebody put the gun in his head and tell him drink, otherwise I'll shoot you. Of course he's going to drink quickly, he's going to be happy actually. Because, you know, I'll die, no, I'll drink my water quickly. So, or eat, or do this, no problem, I'll do it quickly. Thank you very much. He's actually going to thank him for what he's doing for him. If he has no choice, his fast not break. He still is fasting. So these three conditions, he must know the role, he must remember his fasting, and he must have a choice, not under pressure or nobody forcing him to do these things. One of the mustahab of the siyam, it's like, mustahab is good to do it. One of them is to make the iftar early, like in the time of Maghrib, as soon as you hear the adhan with Allahu Akbar, you break your fast. Don't delay it. Some people, they wait, they said, oh, wait until the shahada. Until the muazzin say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna. Why? Nothing in the sunnah. تعجيل الفطر. The Prophet ﷺ said, لا يزال الناس بخير ما عجلوا الفطر. The people, they will continue be in a good way with Allah Azza wa Jal as long as they make the iftar early. Which iftar, not before Maghrib. Like somebody going to say, I'll make it early in Asr time. No, I'm sorry. It's in Maghrib time, but with the adhan. Allahu Akbar, you start, eat the dates, you start drink your water. Dua. The Prophet ﷺ said, always when he used to make dua, he used to say, ذهب الظما وابتلت العروق وثبت الأجر يا واسع الفضل. The thirsty is gone. وابتلت العروق. All my body now, alhamdulillah, get water. And my ajr from Allah Azza, the angel writes it down, alhamdulillah. And he used to make dua. The Prophet ﷺ said, للصائم دعوة لا ترد. The person who breaks his fast, Allah Azza wa Jal accept his dua, never rejected. Never rejected. So it's mustahab to make the dua in the time of iftar. Also said mustahab to delay the suhoor. What if a person breaks his fast on purpose? He wake up, he know that's Ramadan, he know the role, nobody forces him, and eat. He doesn't care. First, the punishment for that, the Prophet ﷺ saw it in Isra and Mi'raj. He saw people hang from the legs. And these people, they used to be heating until the faces was open like very bad way. And Muhammad ﷺ, when he asked Jibreel alayhi salam, who's these people, ya Jibreel? He said, that's the people they used to break the fast in the day of Ramadan. On purpose. On purpose. So, you got a person who breaks his fast on purpose. So there is people, if they break the fast, they must recover this fasting. They must make another days. And there is people, they must make another days and they give fidya. Fidya, it'an, miskin. Fidya, if you break one day fasting, you have to feed one miskin, one poor person. From your meal, like if a person, my meal, $10. I have to feed a person for this day with $10. Another person, mashallah, he eat a lot, $20. So he must feed a person with $20. Another person eat for $50 a meal, mashallah. So he must feed another person for $50. So for each day you break your fast, you have to feed. But some people, they must make the days and they must pay the fidya. So some people, they must make the days only without making paying fidya. Some other people, they must make the days and paying the fidya. Some other people, they must pay the fidya only. They don't pay. Some other people, they must make the days and pay kafara. Kafara is different than fidya. All right, kafara, there is three options for kafara. All right, but first, which one he must make only fasting? He's the one sick, and after the sickness, he become well, alhamdulillah, so he must make his days. Somebody was sick, some sister she get period, some sister she was in the time of giving birth, all the things, or some person he traveled, or somebody like he woke up in the morning of Ramadan, and he thought Fajr is still not yet, and he eat and drink, and after that he found the Fajr already done. So he's not eating on purpose, he eat by mistake, so he must continue his day, and he must make another day. So he must continue his day, because somebody, all right, I break my fast, it's all right, I'll eat the whole day. You cannot do that. You must stop eating, you must continue fasting, but you have to make another day. So that's a person, he must cover his day. What a person, he must. A person like what we call him, he have to pay, like, to make the day, and to pay fidya. A person, he fast, but the first to take fidya, and the woman, she was pregnant, or she was giving breastfeeding. So this woman, she had to do the whole year. She had to do the whole year breastfeeding a child, or she's pregnant for 9 months. So she cannot make that, because she become pregnant in Shawwal or Dhul-Qa'dah, and then she must come to the next Ramadan. She cannot do it. So this woman, she must give the fidya, and after she become well, even after the next Ramadan, she make the days. So her days is still, but she must give fidya. Why? Because if she died, so she already done. Allah Azza wa Jalla is not going to ask her about anything. So if somebody, she was pregnant, or she was breastfeeding, or somebody he was sick and the doctors think he's not going to be well, so he must give fidya. But after that he become well, after the next Ramadan, so he must do his days again. Alright? The third one, a person who give fidya without making fasting. The old people, very old man, very old woman, she cannot fast. All what she had to do, she give fidya for every day. Like if she got 30 days, she cannot fast, or Ramadan 29 days, she must pay 29 for 29 miskin, 29 poor. And you cannot ask her to do another days. The last one, a person, he must make the days and must make kafara. He's the one, he make a big mistake during the day of Ramadan. He had his wife during the day of Ramadan. He couldn't control himself. If he forced his wife, she don't have to fast with him. She don't have to do kafara. But if his wife, she agree with him, both of them, they must make the kafara. So they must make the day, because this day is already gone from them, so they must make it, and then they must make the kafara. What is the kafara? First, عِتْقُ رَقَبَةً. If there is a slavery, he must free a neck, must free a slave. Nothing now. He must fast 2 months. Continuous. Like if he fast 58 days and he becomes sick, he couldn't make the other 2 days, he must make another 2 months. So because of what you've done, it's not right. So be careful. Alright? Or if he cannot fast because this guy, like, he's sick, he must feed 60 poor persons. Alright? So this person, he must make the days, and he must be kafara as well. And the kafara starts from free a slave, or fast 2 months continuous, or you have to feed if you cannot. And all these three, you must be, if you cannot do the first one, you do the second one. But if you can do the first one, you cannot do the second one. One of the ulama, he came to one of the khalifa, and he did that with his wife during the day, and they asked for the kafar. So everybody tell him, first option, to free a neck. So he asked his Imam Malik, he said, what should I do? He said, no, you must fast 60 days, 2 months. He said, how come? Allah Azza give the option first, to free a slave. He said, no, because you can't do that. You can't do that. That's easy for you. You got too much slave. And the slave is not belong to you. It's belong to the Muslim country. So now you have to do fasting. So he let him fast 2 months. But for us, you have to take these three options after each other. First, if you can, there is a slave. If you know there is some slave in some country, Muslim slave or whatever slave, and you can free him, you can give the owner the money and let him go, do it. But I can't. There is no slave now. What should I do? Fast 2 months. I can't. I'm very sick. Pay a money for 60 people or to feed 60 poor person so Allah Azza wa Jal can accept it as kafara. As we said, to use the miswak during the Ramadan, it's like it's halal and it's mustahab as well. If a person wake up in the morning and he found himself junub, he can continue his fasting after he wash. That's no problem at all. Some people, they think if somebody backbite during the Ramadan, during the day of Ramadan, he break his fast. This is not right. He reduce your hasanat, yes. Big biting is bad thing. It's a great sin. But it doesn't break your fast. Some people, they think if a person fast without praying, Allah is not going to accept his fasting. Two different things. You have to pray. Because prayer is even important than fasting. But you cannot tell somebody, because some people they tell, I know so many people they said, Sheikh, I only fast but I don't pray. I cannot tell him, no, Allah doesn't accept it, don't pray, don't even fast. You cannot tell him that. He can fast, because fasting is different than the prayer. But of course, he must pray. Like you cannot just tell him, it's alright, no problem, Allah Azza wa Jalla will forgive you. If you have if anyone died and he had to fast before he died, his wali or his son or his daughter or his wife or her husband, he can fast for her or can fast for him. But that's for condition. Like if he had to fast as well, like for example, he was sick and subhanAllah, during the sickness, he was sick for the last 10 days of Ramadan. And then you continue another 10 days after Ramadan and he passed away. So these 10 days, you can break the fast, you can do the fasting for him. But if he was old, you pay for him the money. Exactly like his situation. You give the money for the people to eat. Like one person every day. But if you got somebody, father, mother, son, daughter, whatever, and you know you should to make this fasting, you can do it for him also, inshallah. One of the things, inshallah, quickly, my brother, because I'm running because I know the time is too short and I want to, like, if somebody have any question, inshallah, we can open the discussion. Salatul Taraweeh, it's a sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is not fard, but is mustahab for all the family to come to Salatul Taraweeh. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did it only 3 nights, and because he was worried the Sahaba will do it as fard, he stopped it. And all of us who know Umar ibn Khattab, he start praying the Sahaba back to pray together. How many raka'ah, Salatul Taraweeh? The strong opinion, the Prophet ﷺ used to do 8 raka'ah and 2 shafa and witr, 11. But the Prophet ﷺ, he never say that's the only raka'ah you can do. So you can do 11, which 8 and 3, ra'a 3, or you can do 13, or you can do 20, or you can do even some ulama, they make it 40. So it's allowed to you, in the nafl, do whatever you want. There is nothing from the Prophet ﷺ to say, you have to do certain. But the majority, the Prophet ﷺ, he used to do only 8 raka'ah, and the shafa, and the witr. Inshallah, we'll open the question for the brothers. And the sister, if they need to know anything about Ramadan. Anybody have any question?
Yes. Old people may not fast. How old?
The age of they cannot fast anymore. He can be 60, but he cannot fast. He can be 70, but he can fast. He can be 80, but he can fast. So it's up to his health. And as I said, in certain fatwa, the one he must give this fatwa is a doctor. Islam, he refers the thing to the doctor. If the doctor said, this man cannot fast, it's going to be very dangerous for his life, In this case, this man, he cannot fast and he must just pay the fidya. He feed one poor person every day. But sometime a person, he's 70, he's 80, subhanAllah, alhamdulillah, his health is very good and he can continue fast, so there is no age limit. Because that's up to the health, not to the age. Alright. What else?
You said in traveling you can fast, you can break fast.
In the fasting, you allow to fast or not fasting.
Yeah.
That's up to you. But the rukhsa, the permission of Allah Azjal to break your fast. فَمَنْ كَانَ مَرِيضًا أَوْ عَلَى سَفَرٍ. The sick and the traveler.
Yes, say for example, I'm traveling I wanna fast.
Yes.
I start from Australia, I just took my suhoor in Australia.
Yes.
And I'm going to Singapore.
Yes.
Or Bangladesh.
Mm-hmm.
And when I'll break my fast?
Big mistake if you fast, I'm telling you. Because you're going to end fast more than 25 hours. And you're going to say, I wish if I take the rukhsa of Allah Azza wa Jal. Really, a lot of people, they do that. They try and, because the problem, Australia starting. Sun starts from here. And every time the aeroplane goes, the sun following you. So you're starting. After 8 hours, you're still starting. After 12 hours, you're just starting. After 16 hours, you're just starting now. So that's why it's better for you to take the permission of the of Allah Azza wa Jal. If you're traveling, just to break your fast.
Okay. If his flight is at 4 p.m., he has to fast up to 4 p.m., get into the plane, and when the plane leaves...
Of course, no. Because the plane maybe is not going to go. Maybe anything is going to take you back. No, that's a different situation. But I'm talking about in general in fasting, like Salatul Qasr. When you start travel, you start your Salat Qasr. When you start travel, you start your breaking fast. So it's up to when you start. Even some ulama said when you pass the border of the residential area of yours. Because that's when starting the time of the Qasr or the breaking fast.
Sheikh, what happens when you're coming back from traveling and then you reach home and you have a salah to do? Do you pray the normal rakat or do you pray the traveling?
Oh, it's finished. You're muqim now.
If you are
that's your home, okay. You pray normal.
Okay.
So as soon as you reach your place,
yeah,
you pray normal.
And on the way, you're a traveler.
On the way, Qasr.
Okay.
Because as soon as you become muqim, khalas. He's right back.
My daughter is around 10 years old. So is it that hard to
fasting? It's not obligatory for her.
So what age she will start?
Bulugh. Mature. As soon as she become mature, like some girls 14, 15, 16, some of them. But why we teach them the Sahaba in the Prophet's time, the wives used to teach the kids to fast. Start for like in the morning, like 2 hours. She's still young. And then after that, another 2 hours. And then when she start feel pain, give her some toy. You know, kids, as soon as you get toy, they forget about the food. And then tell her, you can stop eating, but drink. Drinking doesn't break the fast, no problem. So she can drink, at least she gets something. You know, step by step, until the kids start to get used to that. Because fasting is just like some non-Muslims, when they see us fasting, they cannot believe. Oh, you stop eating from this time until this time, and for us, it's normal. Just 2-3 days, everybody gets used to that. So with the kids as well, just practicing, until inshallah, they can fast. But it's not obligatory. Don't force them. Jazakumullah khair. Mashallah.
Yeah, I wanted to ask. For elderly person,
yes,
it's sometimes difficult to find a poor person to feed every day as a fidya.
Yes.
In that case, if you say nowadays other means are available, like there's a donation request by the lot of agencies. They're saying that you can pay this much money to feed family for a month. Is that an option?
Yeah, of course. If you trust this organization, if they take this money to feed the poor for the kafara, because the money of fidya must be used for fidya. You cannot use it for anything else. It must go to feed family, to feed people. And for you, you can, like for example, if they said $60 enough for the family for the whole month. So he said, all right, I'll not going to fast the whole month. No, You must pay from what you eat. Your meal, $10 a day, you must give $300 if you eat fast the whole month. It doesn't matter how much.
No, I'm not saying that. Theoretically, say, even in Bangladesh, if it's difficult to find sometimes a poor person every day, it becomes impractical sometimes.
In Bangladesh?
In Bangladesh.
Send it to Egypt. Like, Bangladesh rich people.
Every day you try to find one, it becomes very impractical. You will not even get somebody every day ask him to come and in that case,
yeah, you said, yeah, of course, you can give it to somebody else to send it to you. Like, you don't have to give it yourself to the person if you don't find. Like, for example, in Australia, very hard to find people like that. People go, alhamdulillah, Central Link, they get money. So we take it to another place so we can feed people there. There is nothing wrong with that at all. Yeah.
A solution to that problem is this, okay, that I give that person, that poor person, money so that he can eat for 60 days?
Yeah, according to...
Same person for 60 days,
yeah.
But not 60 different days?
If you don't have...
60 days food?
You can give it to a person, you feed him every day, or you can give it to 60 people. That's up to you. It's up to...
That same person give money
yes,
for 60
you
days?
Can, yeah, yeah. Same person, or you can give it to, but for every day you feed somebody. So it can't be the same person because nobody else. He's a poor person. So it's fine. It's no problem. So it's all right, you can take it outside. Like, it's no issue at all.
So what about if you feed 10 people in one day?
Yeah, alhamdulillah. That's jazakallah khairan. Of course, yeah. We're talking about the minimum. But somebody wanted to feed 10 people. Somebody, alhamdulillah, is Allah khair. You can do it
in one day, like 60 people
yes.
in one day.
Yeah, because that's why some feed, yeah, you have to wait. If you think, I was sick, she was pregnant, and she think like she can make it before Ramadan, the next Ramadan, and she couldn't. Now I have to give for 60. So every 60 people are going to be fed in one day. So,
what will be the traveling distance
for
a person to break fast?
To break fast, like the salah, exactly. Like the salah. The ulama, they have different opinion about the salah. Some of them, they said, as soon as you pass the residential area, like where are you living, there is the people where they live, if you cross this border, that's where the traveling starts.
They say about like
80 kilo, 80. Some of them said 80 kilo from above. But some of them, they said even if as soon as you pass the residential area. It's different opinion, but strong opinion, like 80 kilo. Like.
Second question is that if somebody breakfast on purpose multiple times in the month of Ramadan, what will be the kafara? Just one time or multiple?
No, multiple, for each day.
For each day?
Yeah, it's up to what he done. Like, if he just breakfast eating and drinking, so he must do the other day and make the fidya.
Because I hear that if somebody make like a multiple kafara, it's only one time.
No. Like, now this person, he break one day. So he must do for the day. And they break another day, he must do for the day. Each day individual.
So what about a normal, healthy person who, like, doesn't fast? On purpose, just
on
eat.
Purpose? That's a great thing.
Yeah, that's a great thing. What will be the kafara? Is it kafara or what?
No, he need to make tawbah, that's why. That's a different. Yeah, he will make tawbah first.
Yes.
He will make tawbah first, yes. And he starts like because this person is not like a good person, but he don't want to call this year. Sorry, brothers.
Like three, four years later or 5 years later,
yeah.
He realizes.
He make tawbah. No, that's different. That's this person. He need to make tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he start fast. And they start fast with the normal days
right.
To come
days
up because he wasn't sent already, like he was doing sent. Yeah. So that's
if somebody is flying from here to Melbourne, does it make him a traveler and he doesn't need to fast?
No, he can take the ruqsa as well. He can take the permission. Because one of the things, my brother, some people they think like because now the traveling has become easy and Allah Azza wa Jalla knows. It's going to be aeroplane. Allah knows it's going to be fasting to take us without even feeling pain or anything like that. But that's a rukhsa, that's a gift from Allah Ajal. Now, brother is going to give me this thing, or it's not for me?
Not all right.
But if you give it to me, I will say, Jazakumullah khair, I'll take it. I will never. But if I said, no, I don't want it, that's, you know, Allah Azzajal is giving you gift. So why you reject it? He knows.
There are some them, there are some sisters, as you said, regarding the pregnancy and breastfeeding, and they come past.
Yes.
So sometimes,
that's what he said.
Sometimes they are pregnant, and then obviously. So they give birth, and then obviously they can't fast, and they can make up the fall coming year. But
yes.
Then she goes breastfeeding. And they say next year she's pregnant again.
Yes.
And then again breastfeeding. And again, so it's going continuously.
She will be the fidya.
She'll be the, now, what if she didn't know before? And now she didn't know. Now she knows that she can. She was actually making up the fast.
She can make the fast. But she must be the fidya. Every year before the next Ramadan starts, she must be the fidya.
So now she had like 60 or 70 mufas.
If she can do it, she, and it's not necessary to do it continuous. This one is not continuous.
Yes, yeah.
This one can do like Monday, Thursday, like.
Yeah, yeah.
So she can cover it.
She has to pay the fidya.
Yes.
Whatever
the fidya must be paid. Yes.
And then she has to make up as well.
Yes.
Did you tell him he break the fast when he go on medical?
I am.
It take only 1 hour.
Doesn't matter.
How come it take only 1 hour by plane and the break the fast?
And he is 1,000 kilo.
It doesn't go by coming 1,000 kilo.
No,
it go by.